Yep.
All right, we're here with Jess. How do you say your last name, Jess?
Steinhilber.
Steinhilber?
Steinhilber.
Jess Steinhilber of recent internet fame from the Strongman Revival video. Many of you may not recognize her because she's not wearing her blue shirt and she's not running around screaming like a lunatic. So, right? You were a little crazy. So, let's talk a little bit about the video. So, you were at the Weekend Revival.
Yeah.
So for those out there that were unaware of what was going down, was that just one big weekend where we threw a lot of weight at you and said, we don't care if you use good form, just get this weight over your head?
No, absolutely not.
But are you sure? Because that's what a lot of the people out there seem to think it was.
No, that's probably the only really heavy lift that we did the whole weekend.
Well, we had our Olympic lifting portion where we went over the snatch, but we kept the weight pretty light.
Yeah.
Because it was really skill-based for that portion, but people, you know, behind their keyboards like to assume they know everything.
True.
So, we had a strongman portion of the weekend, right?
Yeah.
In which Kat led. Kat is our resident strongman coach. She's a complete badass, stronger than
awesome.
Most men here and women, and competes and on a national level. So she went over the axle, right? In which case, tell us a little bit what happened during that strongman portion of the weekend.
She talked about a couple of different movements, a couple of different strongman movements, but then the only thing that we actually practiced was the axle clean and jerk. It was my first time. It was a lot of people's first time doing it. So we learned about how it's a thick bar, so you can't grip it the normal way. You have to kind of do a reverse grip and pull it up to your chest and then switch your grip quick. So it's awkward. It's definitely not your standard clean and jerk.
So you didn't necessarily make that move look more awkward than it should have been. Maybe a little bit.
Maybe a little bit.
We feel here at Albany CrossFit and CrossFit Clifton Park, we pay some little or no attention to your form.
I'd say more than some attention.
More than some. I didn't even throw that as an option because I assumed it was not true. So more than some. So it's not often the case in which we load up a foreign bar and say, hey Jess, get this over your head any way possible.
No. Definitely not. I'm always encouraged to scale and to check when you go out the door, so.
Great. Well, that's good news. And so a lot of people also thought that was an Olympic lift. Do you understand the difference? Are you smarter than most of the people out there that thought that was an Olympic lift? We know you're smarter than most of them. Let's not beat around the bush. But do you understand, and did we make it clear, Olympic lifting and strongman lifting are two very different
things? Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Did you at any point think you were doing an Olympic squat clean?
No.
Did you think you were in the Olympics at that time?
No.
No, all right, so you knew more than what, so we're getting, you knew what was going on. You were aware of your surroundings.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about the weight. That axle is not the same weight as our barbells,
no,
correct?
No, it's what, 20 pounds?
It's about 20 pounds.
Yeah.
Do you know the difference between the axle and the barbell?
Yeah, well, the axle is thicker, a lot thicker, it's lighter, and it doesn't, like, have bearings on it.
So right, so it doesn't spin.
Yeah.
Right, so you have not been that educated in this topic, but you know a lot more than the people out there.
I guess so.
What about the weight? A lot of people think, it sounds to me, from what I'm reading and hearing, women in general should just stay in the kitchen, maybe.
barefoot
and pregnant. I believe in that, honestly. That's my firm belief. But I wouldn't mind a strong woman in the kitchen also.
Yeah, sure.
But were you intimidated by the weight? Do you think women shouldn't lift heavy weights?
No, I don't think so at all. I was intimidated by the weight slightly because it was a PR for me, but I surpassed that this weekend, so.
Right, so at the time on the axle, that was approximately
110.
110. Tell everybody what you clean and jerked with Olympic form this past weekend.
115.
So 115. So that part of the limiting factor with the axle wasn't just your strength, because you're stronger than that, mm-hmm. but the fact that it was a foreign object.
Oh, yeah. It was awkward movement for me. I had never done the continental clean before. So I mean, that didn't get me so much, but definitely it was just new. Different.
It was just something different. And do you think trying new things in life is generally a good rule of thumb?
Yes, absolutely.
How many times have you done the axle since then?
I went to a strongman class where we did it, so probably like 8 or 9 lifts.
Do you feel a little more comfortable with it now?
Yeah, definitely.
Do you think you would look quite as goofy?
Hopefully not. I'm working on it.
You can make anything look pretty goofy.
Yeah.
Do you agree with that?
Yeah, I would agree with that.
What is it about you?
I don't know. I'm just gone.
So, do you think there's a time and a place to incorporate that into your fitness routine?
Oh, yeah, definitely. It's fun. I like doing the strongman stuff because it's more applicable to life because it's awkward objects, and in life you don't always have a barbell. So
that's a great point. And do we ever throw those axles or any strongman movements into a standard wad?
No.
Here? So do we ever give you this awkward and heavy weight and say, now go, don't worry about form, just do this, go, go, go?
No, never.
Should we start doing that?
You probably get a lot more haters if we did that.
I gotta say, like, I'm a big fan of haters personally, so it only spreads the word,
yeah.
Right? Did you think when you were doing that lift, that day, that Sunday at the Revival, did you ever imagine you'd one day be this huge internet sensation?
No.
How far did it reach? Tell us. You were telling me earlier somebody saw you doing it.
Oh, yeah. I've talked to people that are in, you know, across the country who saw others watching the video, and some thought it was badass, and some people thought we looked like idiots, so.
It was somewhere in the middle.
Yeah.
We're kind of like badass idiots.
Yeah.
But I'm okay with that.
Yeah.
So any lessons you've learned from this experience?
I just appreciate being able to see myself on film even more, because now I know what I need to correct, but definitely people are very quick to pass judgment before they even know what's going on, so just take everything that people say on the internet with a grain of salt.
Did you, prior to the comments on YouTube and everything else, did you realize your knees actually go in when you squat? Had that ever been pointed out?
Oh yeah, that's been pointed out to me since I first started doing CrossFit. And
so
I'm
you were aware
trying,
of that?
Yes, I'm well aware that my knees go in.
Is it true after that weekend you spent the night in the hospital? Because your back was so hurt from that heavy lift.
No, that's not true.
What was your initial reaction? Was it anger?
I was embarrassed. I was really embarrassed because I knew that my knees were going in. The first thing I said when you posted that video was, look at my knees going in.
So what we've learned in this interview, you've already said it before, but you say it again, videoing this and is a good way for you to learn your faults.
Oh, yeah.
So you learned more about your form from this video.
Yeah, absolutely.
Wow.
Too bad, you know, all the other people had to learn that about my form as well.
But you know what? Is it more of a motivator for you to fix
it?
And was there anger? Are you angry because of this video? Are you mad at me?
No, I'm not mad at you.
You're not mad at me?
Good. No.
Are you glad in retrospect? Would you rather it happened, rather it didn't happen? I'll tell you my thoughts. I'm glad it happened.
Okay.
But what's your thoughts?
I'm glad it happened too.
Are you just saying that because I said it?
No, I am, because I learned a lot from it.
You are? You learned? Anything you'd like to say to the people that watched it that were very quick to judge? I know you've probably thought about this. What would you like to say?
I would just say, you can't just look at something and judge before you know anything about it. I mean, I didn't know anything about CrossFit at first. I looked at it and I was like, I want to learn more about this. I'm like, they're a bunch of crazy people. So.
Do you still feel that way?
Yeah, we're definitely crazy. But
are you glad you CrossFit?
Oh, absolutely.
Are you glad to be a part of the CrossFit community?
Yes, definitely.
Are you glad that within our CrossFit community here, we implement outside sports such as strongman?
Yeah, definitely. It's awesome, yeah.
So do you think we could all get along?
I think so, yeah. Isn't that the concept of CrossFit?
Do you think you're the Rodney King of CrossFit at this point? Like, why can't we all get along? Like, that could be you. Like, strongman, you know, lifters, endurance, like, why can't we all get along?
I would love to be that person that just promotes the love between all sports. Yeah.
I think you are that person.
Great.
We are proud to have you at Albany CrossFit, CrossFit Clifton Park.
Thank
you. We will get you back on that axle, and we'll get you back on some squats, and we'll post it online to show your improvement, and certainly by June 20th of next year.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Okay. Thank you.
And pull that bar into your shins. Touch your... Okay, now reset those feet. Strong dip drive. Yeah.